Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. So I'm Shubham and you're watching Let's Create an App. So in this video we are going to talk about one of the Android functionality, and that is a toast view. Toast view is simply a message displayer in which some message is displayed and it will automatically disappear after 2-3 seconds. So this functionality is not in iOS, so we can create this functionality by using a label and by just dynamic height and width according to our need. So I've already created a demo for this thing. So let's look into the demo. So as I click on this short toast, it will appear a short message, a single line message, and it's having some height and some width. And as I click on this long toast, means the message is quite long. So it will automatically dynamically change the width and height of that label. Height and width totally depend on the content which we pass in that text or in that label. So this is a new concept for everyone. So we are going to learn this thing in this video. And if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. Don't forget to hit the like button and share the video. Let's create an app. So open in Xcode, click on single view application, click on next. Just give the name whatever you want to give. I'm just giving toast view iOS and click on next and save where you want to save this project. Now, after creating this project, we have to move to this view controller. We don't have any kind of UI part in this application, so we are directly moving to the view controller class. Now we have to create one extension, and this extension is of UI view controller type, so that we can call this method from anywhere. So now let's write this method, so that function, and the name of this method is just like show toast, and this will take one parameter. That is message, which will be passed by the user, and it is of string type. And this is done. Now we have to create one label in this method. So let's create one label. So let toast label is equals to UI label, kind of this. Now we have to set some properties of this toast label before proceeding further. So toast label dot text is equals to message which the user passed, toast label dot text alignment is equals to dot center, toast label dot font, okay, we need to pass the font size also, so UI font dot system font, and we can pass anything. 18 is the good size, so I'm passing 18. Now we have to pass the toast label color dot text color is equals to UI color dot white. We have to also pass the background color of this toast label, so toast label dot background color is equals to UI color dot black, and we have to give the opacity to this color also, so with alpha, and the alpha is just like 0.6. this is good alpha. Now we have to set one more important property of this toast label, that is a number of lines. So toast label dot number of lines is equals to, we have to set this 0, so whatever number lines user pass, it will take automatically that number of lines. Otherwise, if we fix anything 1, 2, 3, then it will only contains that number of line. Now we have to find the intrinsic content size of this text label, or we can say the toast label. Intrinsic content size is the size of content which having in that property, in that label or in that text field. We can use in anything like this. So right now we are using label, so we can say that whatever size of that label when content is passed in that label. So let text size is equals to toast label dot intrinsic content size. So this is a CG rect type property, CG size type property. So this will return height and width simply. Now we have to also find the width of the label first. If user passed less content, then the width should be less. And if user passed more than 2 lines content or 1 line content, the width should remain fixed according to the screen size. So label width is equals to, now we have to find the minimum, like we have to compare which is what is the width of this label. If the label width is less, then it will be choose. If the label width is more, then the width of the screen will be choose. So first we have to define the window, just like get the screen size. So for that we have to write one thing like guard, and in this we have to use let window is equals to UI application dot shared dot key window, just simply like this. And in the return else statement we have to use return this thing. Now in the minimum we have to first text size dot width, and in Y we have to use window dot frames dot width, something like this. So whatever is less it will choose that thing. And we have to minus 40 over here so that it will automatically decrease the size of the window, means the width of this label. Now we have to set the frames of this toast label. So toast label dot frames is equals to cg rect, like this. And we have to choose this method in this. Now let's get more space, and in x should be 20, y. So y is we have to use window dot frames dot height. So by doing this we will get the height of the whole screen. Now we have to minus this height with 90, so we get this toast label little bit up from the bottom, and the width is label width whatever we get, and the height is text size dot height, like this. Now we have to center the content of this, center this label with respect to the screen. So toast label dot center dot x is equals to window dot center dot x, something like this. Now we can choose the corner radius, or do according to our need it's a corner radius, or if you want to do anything else you can do that thing. So I'm just doing a toast label dot layer dot corner radius is equals to 10, toast label dot layer dot mask to bound is equals to true, this thing. Now we have to add this toast label on the sub view. So this toast label will be add on a window, so window dot add subview, and this that is a toast label, like this. Now we have to animate this toast label. So for animation we have to simply use a simple animation UI view, UI view dot animate dot animate, and in this we have to use this completion blocks block method, so that whenever this time interval is complete, it will automatically remove this view from the super view. In the animation we have to change the toast label alpha, so toast label dot alpha, this one, and we have to make it 0, so it will automatically reduce this alpha from 1 to 0. It will look like that, it's fading down. And in the completion handler we have to write we have to remove this thing from the window. So we have to write text toast label dot remove from window, toast label, toast label dot remove from super view, yes, remove from super view, this one. So we have done now this thing. Now let's create one button first and check that with that button. Now let's set the constraint, default constraint, just like center horizontal and vertical, move to the view controller, create the outlet of this button, sorry, action, on click and put action now, and then let's run again. We have done each and everything over here. So yeah, it's working, we get this label, we get this toast over here, but it's not looking good, the HN is not working fine. So let's change something. And the width is not exactly what we want over there. So let's increase the width to 20, so that this will get a little bit space at the ends. So let's see now that it is working fine or not. Now it's looking cool, but the height is also a little bit issue, that height is not good. So let's also increase the height to 10. Now let's run and let's see that it is working fine or not. So I guess now this will work fine and it looks good. Now let's increase the size of the content which we have in this button. So hello world, and I'm just copying this thing string and pasting this thing over many times so that we can get a big string like this. Now let's run and check that this will looks good or not. So as I click on this, this will not working fine. As you see that we are only seeing a single line, this is not working. So as we see that height is not working fine, now we have to make the height also dynamic as we make the width dynamic. So for making the height dynamic, first we have to find the number of lines in our label, that how many lines we have. So for that we have to use some simple logic. So let create that logic. So not here, we have to use after the size, let label height, and this label height is just like we have to first find the height. So we have to put some logic, that is our text size dot width divided by window dot frame dot width. So if the text, suppose if the text size is like 800 and we have a window of like 320, then we automatically get three lines or four lines of text, just like four lines. So now we are getting a four lines of text, and we know we having a one line is equals to 22 or 21. So I'm using 30 as one line of code. So I'm just into 30. So if we are getting two lines of text in that label, then it will automatically gives me a height of 60. So this will automatically dynamically change the height according to its need. But if the text is of one line, then how we can judge? So for that we have to again write one more variable. We have to create one more variable, and that is label height LBL. And in this we have to use a max method, that again it will take two parameters in which we have to come. This is a comparable thing which will be max. It will return that thing. So in this we have to first pass label height, and the second is which we have to pass the text size dot height, like this. Now we have to change this height, and we can do one more thing, that we have to remove this plus 10 over here, and we can directly pass that plus 10 over here, like plus 20. And let's change this to, or we can give a good name, just like adjusted height, this one. Now I'll copy this thing and paste over here. Now let's see that it is working good or not now. So for me, I guess this will work fine now. So this will work fine, but its text is going downwards. So now let's manage the Y position of this frame. So this one, and let's put this thing in a bracket. So this will printing this will showing the label at 90 pixels below from the bottom. Now we have to just minus one more thing, and that is a height, whatever height we have adjusted at that moment. So adjusted height. Now let's run and check that this will work fine or not. So yeah, it's working fine. It's completely working fine, and it's looking cool as well. Now let's change a text to some more bigger text, something like this. Now let's run again and set and check that it is looking cool or not now. So this is completely working according to our need. And let's remove the text, whole text, and just a simple one line of text, and run again and see that it is working fine or not. So it's working fine. So we successfully created a toast view as we have in Android, and we can place this thing in anywhere in any screen with any n number of lines of text. So this is for today. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. And please don't forget to share this video a lot. This helps me a lot. Thank you.